Hello everyone. So today's topic is write a C program to check whether the given number, or you can say that entered number, is palindrome number or not. Okay. So before we go ahead with the C program part, let me tell you one thing properly, that what is the exact meaning of palindrome. Okay. So if we are asking user that you enter one number, okay, then at that time user will enter any one number, for example 122 or 98 or 86, any number. Okay, so let's say for example user has entered 121. Okay, that is the number entered by user. So palindrome means, first of all, you find out the reverse of the entered number. Okay, so entered number is what? 121. And what is the reverse of 121? Reverse of 121 is also 121 only. Okay, so basically, if entered number and reverse number, if both are same, then we can say it is what? Palindrome number. I will tell you one more example. For example, user enter 45. Okay, now reverse of 45 is what? 54. Okay, now 45 and 54 are not same, so that is not the palindrome number. Okay, so now let's go ahead with the programming part. Okay, so hash include stdio.h, hash include kono.h, that is the header file. Okay, after that void main function, open the bracket, and we have used some variables like integer n, then num, then reverse, and I mean short form rev. Okay, and in the next line also we have initialized the value of reverse initially as what? 0. Okay, so that is the declaration part or initialization part. Now next thing is printf, enter the number. So here we are asking user that you enter one number, scanf, and then %d, and then %n. So whatever number user will enter, that will get stored in the variable n. Okay, now after that, in the next line we are writing num is equal to n, which means what? That whatever number entered by user, okay, that same number we are storing in one more variable. Okay, so later on when we will check using if condition, that time instead of n we will use num as a variable. Okay, now the logic part is this, that is the while loop. So first of all, while n not equal to 0, okay, n not equal to 0, open the bracket, reverse equal to, okay, reverse into 10. First of all, value of reverse, initial value here, it is what? 0. Okay, so what is 0 into 10? We know it is 0 only. After that, plus sign, n modulo 10. Now as per our assumption, n is 121, that is our assumption. Okay, so 121 and modulo sign means, now we have to check for remainder, modulo sign means. So 121 modulo 10, so remainder will be what? 1. So answer of this bracket is 0, then plus sign is there in between, and answer of this bracket is 1. So what is 0 plus 1? 1. So at this point, new value of reverse is what? 1. Now next line, n is equal to n divided by 10. Now when it comes to division sign, we always check for the quotient, and when it comes to modulo sign, we check for the remainder. Okay, so n is equal to n modulo by 10. So 121 divided by 10, the answer is 12. Okay, so at this point, the latest value of reverse is 1 and latest value of n is 12. So now the closing bracket indicates we have to go back again that condition part, while n not equal to 0. So right now n is not 121, it is 12. So obviously 12 is not equal to 0, so condition is true, and then it will go inside. Now reverse equal to, now tell me the previous value of reverse, it was 1. So first of all, 1 into 10, so answer of this bracket is what? 10. That that is for sure. Okay, and then plus sign as it is. Now answer of this bracket. First of all, it is n modulo 10, which means 12 modulo 10. So when it comes to 12 modulo 10, remainder is what? 2. Which means answer of this bracket is 10 plus answer of this bracket is what? 2. So 10 plus 2. So reverse is equal to what? 12. That is the latest value of reverse, 12. Now n is equal to n divided by 10, means 12 divided by 10. So here you will get quotient equal to what? 1. That means reverse equal to what you are getting? 12, and n at this point, n is equal to what? 1. Again while loop, 1 not equal to 0. Again it will go inside of this. Reverse equal to, now reverse into 10 means what? 12 into 10. So 12 into 10 is what? 120. So answer of that first bracket is 120. Then plus sign here. 1 modulo 10. So remainder here it will be 1. So 120 plus 1. Reverse equal to what? 121. Okay. So that is the latest value of reverse. That is 121. Then n equal to 1 divided by 10. So at this point n will be what? 0 at this point. Okay. So n is 0 and reverse is what? 121. Closing bracket, again while loop condition we will check. So now condition is what? False. So come out of this while loop. Okay. And we know that latest value of reverse is 121. So we have used if condition. If reverse equal to num. Num means this thing. Original number. Our original number. Okay, this one. So 121 is the value of reverse. It is equal to original number is also 121. Okay. So condition is true only. Therefore, it will print that %d means this value. 121 is what? Palindrome. And then get ch and close the bracket. So here we have one sample output, but in which we have not used 121 number, but we have used 21. And we know that reverse of 21 is what? 12. So obviously 21 is not the palindrome number. Thank you.